The High Court's International Crimes Division yesterday granted bail to 36 former members of the Forum for Democratic Change, FDC, who were arrested in Kenya on terrorism charges. Justice Susan Okalanya set stringent conditions for their release, ordering each individual to pay a cash bail of 2 million shillings and deposit their passports and travel documents with the Deputy Registrar of the Court. The court has also mandated the Deputy Registrar to notify immigration authorities of the travel ban imposed on the suspects.
I just want to submit that there is no person who is supernatural. I may be an advocate, a respected advocate, but I may not be at the same, I cannot be in two places at the same time. So there are some things which may be out of control. So, my Lord, as you consider in this application, you look at the distance between the sureties and then the applicants and the sureties.
And the court has decided to grant bail to each of the applicants. Each surety of the applicant shall execute a non-cash bond of 50 million. Non-cash bond for each surety.
Erias Lukwago, lead counsel for the accused, had submitted that the presumption of innocence is a cornerstone of the justice system, emphasizing the importance of granting bail. The court further stipulated that if the state fails to commit the suspects for trial within 6 months from October 31, 2024, they will be automatically discharged along with their sureties.
But I order that their passports be deposited, those that have passports and travel documents, to this court.
This development follows the controversy surrounding the arrest and deportation of the FDC members from Kenya. The group, comprising 34 men and 2 women, were accused of traveling to Kenya to receive terrorism training. However, their lawyers and party officials claimed they were attending a leadership and governance training course. October every year is a sensitization month for cancer. Yesterday, the doctors at the Cancer Institute met with breast cancer survivors. The doctors also warned that there should be a change in the mindset that breast cancer only affects women. Dr. Najib Bogere at the Cancer Institute revealed that breast cancer cases among men are on the rise.
Kukula umabere, ekwata nebasaja. Nenga mbunje tera ukwata abakazi. Nenga mushitundu mushikumi usanga nga chitundu nga shenda mutano kutuka shenda mumwenda etera kupata chi abashala nenga basaja batera kutwala chitundu nga emu.
Echiku Emaltino from Serere is a breast cancer survivor who was declared cancer free after getting treatment at the institute. He shared his testimony as a breast cancer survivor and he urged men to undergo breast cancer screening.
I am one of the cancer survivors, breast cancer survivors. I stayed with this cancer for almost more than 5 years. But once I came to Cancer Institute, I was treated. I am now fully okay.
According to Uganda Cancer Institute, UCI, they record at least 40 new cases of breast cancer in men annually at the Kampala Breast Care Center, with many presenting with advanced diseases. Research reports on breast cancer in men in Uganda are scarce. However, a report of a study done in northern Uganda and published in the scientific journal Breast Disease in 2021 by Pecorella Irene and colleagues shows that male breast cancer MBC accounts for 6.2% of breast cancers. Kamala Harris yesterday criticized Donald Trump's latest remarks in which he vowed to protect women in America whether they like it or not, describing her White House rival's comments as very offensive. Trump appointed 3 of the justices to the U.S. Supreme Court, who formed the conservative majority that overturned federal abortion's rights. As fallout from the 2022 decision spreads, Trump has taken to boasting at public events and in social media posts that he would protect women and make sure that they wouldn't be thinking about abortion.
It's just, it actually is, I think, very offensive to women in terms of not understanding their agency, their authority, their right, and their ability to make decisions about their own lives. including their own bodies. And this is just the latest on a series of reveals by the former president of how he thinks about women.